Campfire Story.
This story posted by Hack Shock. My life didn't work out as I'd planned, so when my terminally ill and bedridden grandma asked me to move into her small cottage in rural Ireland to care for her, I reluctantly agreed. It was better than sleeping on park benches, but only just. I had to bathe her, feed her, clean her, and listen to her interminable tall tales about the myths and legends of the Emerald Isle. In particular, my grandma seemed to hold some deep belief that birds are linked to our life and death, akin to guardian angels, or some similar nonsense. I never really listened. I mean, who the hell cares? All I was interested in was inheriting her quaint cottage, worth a pretty penny. But one of her ridiculous beliefs did grab my attention. That her life was linked to the robin redbreast which sung their shrill tin whistle shriek in her small garden. And in the forest beyond. The day the robins stop singing is the day I'll leave this mortal realm, she said, smiling in that sweet, kind, grandmotherly way which I hated. And sure enough, she defied the doctor's prognosis, clinging on to life for 5 freaking months. Until one day, the robin redbreast were all gone. I found her, cold as ice, staring out of her bedroom window, her face seemingly at peace. Finally, the cottage was mine, and all it took was some poisoned birdseed. The perfect crime, am I right? There was no funeral. It's what Grandma wanted, I sighed to her friends from the village. I guess Grandma's buried somewhere nearby, in a pauper's grave. I placed Grandma's cottage on the housing market and set about selling all of her things for beer money. In the meantime, I explored the local countryside, happier than I'd ever been. But what was weird was how quiet the woods and meadows were. Birdsong is something you get so used to, living a rural life, that you only notice it when it's gone. And since Grandma's passing, I swear I've not heard a single tweet from any of our feathered friends. This can't all be down to the poison pellets I'd spread. Surely, maybe I killed a few robins and a pigeon or two, but no matter how far I walked, still I heard nothing but the wind whispering in the trees and the gossipy chatter of bustling hedgerows. I'd hear cows and sheep and dogs as normal, but not a peep from anything avian. Unsettled, I took to bird watching, using an ancient pair of binoculars which I haven't sold on eBay yet. The birds are still there, many, many more of them than I'd realized. On every tree, every branch, magpies, starlings, every type of Irish bird stands silently, every beady eye staring dead set on me. What was it that Grandma had said? Beware the man on whom the birds don't pass their blessing, for he's surely destined not for heaven, but for a place the birds don't dare mention. Subscribe or I will haunt your house. If you like this video, please do comment, like, and subscribe for more. Thanks for hearing. See you in the next one.